Hey guys, Jill here for Premiere Basics. Are you someone that uses a lot of effects and always has to copy and paste them so you could reuse them? Well, today I will give you a solution for that, because I will teach you how to create your own presets. By now, I think you already know how to make little animations to your clips with either a crop effect, transform effect, or maybe just with emotion properties. If not, then check out our dedicated tutorials in the top right corner or in the playlist, which is linked down in the description below. Now, to turn these effects into a preset, right click on the effect and select Save Preset. A new window pops up where you can give this preset a custom name and set the type. Type means the way the preset has to interpret the effect. Now, if you choose Anchor to the endpoint, it will start from the beginning of your clip. Anchor to outpoint will calculate from the outpoint. So this will just count the amount of frames that you use between your keyframes, meaning it will not be altered whether another clip is shorter or longer. This is perfect to use for lower thirds or other pop-ups where the animations always have to start at the same point and have the same length. If you select the scale type, it will not remember the amount of keyframes, but it will interpret the length of the effect and the entire clip. So the place where your keyframes are positioned relative to the length of your clip. Meaning it doesn't really matter whether another clip is longer or shorter. It will automatically rescale the length of your effect to the length of the clip. And of course, you can also add a description to this preset. Now, don't forget to press OK to save this, by the way. And once it is saved, you can find this in the Effects panel under the Presets tab. Now, you can create as many presets as you want, actually. Now, the best part about presets is it doesn't have to contain just one effect. No, you can select multiple effects and you can bundle them all together as a preset, which again makes your workflow way more efficient. Now, using presets is super useful whenever you want all of your videos to have the same transitions, whether it's a zoom transition, a swipe transition, etc. You can also save Lumetri effects as presets, and that way you can create your own LUTs inside Premiere Pro. Now, I personally have a specific color preset for my studio files because the lighting here never changes. So why waste time with color grading when I can easily just drag and drop, right? Now, just a small tip when you edit a lot. You can not only make effect presets, but you can also make custom sequence presets and even export presets, making your workflow even faster whenever you need your video in other sizes. To top this all off, I'm giving you one preset bundle for free. You can find the link to it in the description down below. Once you've downloaded these, right click on presets in the effect panel and select import presets. And bada bada bing, bada bada boom, you can use them whenever you want now. Have fun using them. I'll see you guys next week. And as always, stay creative.